Good morning, everyone. So as we start our divine worship, let us pray. Our dear gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we come to you this afternoon, Lord, that you please, may you please send all the angels to sing with us and to praise you, Lord, with all our hearts and verses and prayer. So for our Sabbath expression of praise, we will be singing sweet by and by.
Thank you. We come with hearts ready Fill us with your Holy Spirit. Open your sacred truth that we may understand with you. We ask in Jesus' name.
Chapter 11, verse 19 to 20. Book of Ezekiel, chapter 11, verse 19 to 20. I'm reading in New King James Version. Chapter 11, verse 19. Then I will give them one heart, and I will put a new spirit within them, and take the stony heart out of their flesh, and give them a heart of flesh. Verse 20, then they may walk in my statutes, and keep my judgments, and do them, and they shall be my people, and I will be their God.
Thank you.
Thank you.
truly establish the fact that our hearts have been trusted in choosing our lifeline partners. Neither could we rely on our emotions in engaging with someone in a commitment of love. This part, even before we can finish that part, I'd like to draw from the scriptures how the Lord can change the stony heart into a heart that is accorded with His greater plans. We'd like to get a heart that is aligned in the will of God, so that it would choose not to rely in itself, but to find confidence and wisdom in God's plan. Let's bow our heads. Father, as we read your words once more, may we learn in our young people the importance of transformation that only your Spirit can perform in our hearts today. May you prepare each one of them, not only in the mission field, in the profession and chosen careers, but most especially to find meaningful relationships with you and with someone whom they will share life in and for eternity in heaven. We ask this for Jesus. Amen. I believe, personally, when you choose someone to share life together, they're not chosen because of their careers. Let me repeat that. Others may not yet be ready to hear that. Let me do it again so that we wouldn't miss. I personally believe that our chosen careers should never be the index in choosing our lifetime partners. We tend to think that when I'm a doctor, I should also choose a doctor. Many have been made to believe that, proving only later in life that it could never be a reliable basis for choosing your lifetime partner. I suggest that in choosing a lifetime partner, a person with whom you would share life and love for eternity, is someone who also has a meaningful relationship with God. Whether he's an engineer, a doctor, an agriculturist, a nurse, or an educator, my choice will be grounded on the character God has developed in that person. Therefore, it is my conclusion then that we apply to our children. If we miss the development of character, then we also teach them to develop their character in Christ. You cannot look for someone or expect it from someone which you do not have. We do not want to be selfish in an all-give relationship of love, thinking only what we can get from the person, but are not willing to give in exchange. What we expect to find in someone who will share love with must also first be exemplified in your own life. So kung nag-aanap ka ng kasipag, hindi dapat sipag ka. It is so self-centered and selfish to expect someone to be masipag when you're not. This is not how husband and wife complement in their character. That's why character development is a lifetime journey, so should our marriages and relationships in love be lifetime. If it is character development, then it should start as young as our children are. Never teach them to an older age when they could learn the presence of God. Deuteronomy chapter 5 covers the entire Shema that says, love God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul. This is to be the foundation of every and any other relationship that must be experienced among humans. Young people, it is in this educational institution that you should cultivate culture and motivate among yourselves that character development is the foremost. It is only when you are mature enough to carry such responsibilities, menial as they are, as people of your character development, are you ready to commit in a relationship leading to marriage? Teka, teka, Jordan. Marriage, ayan. When you see, our understanding of love must be based on a covenantal relationship. That means, we commit ourselves into the development of a new alliance of relationship, committing ourselves that we will do our part, even if the other may fail. Love must start right in the warmth of true friendship if it has to last long in marriage. That's why it must always carry the end in mind from the very beginning. Young people, never seek to commit with someone if you do not intend that relationship to lead you to a oneness in Christ. Friendship has to be friendship. Marriage will have its bounds. A distinction between the two kinds of relationships must be very clear. That's why it is important to start where it should be so that it would end right in a meaningful relationship. So, I would say, doctors, seek someone with whom you could share lifetime commitment in doing your ministry. Hindi yung doktor sa kapwa doktor lang. I hate that. It does not help a sound biblical basis. What I would say, it must be the character. I just drove a 10-hour trip from Bicol yesterday. It was my expectation to see the Mayon volcano, glowing with all its fuel. They say it's a danger in its beauty.
so as to catch up while the sun is still high and see the grandeur of the Mayanuku Kingdom. But I never had that opportunity. I had to wait the following day at early morning to see its landscape. So I went out of the balcony where we were staying and located the Mayanuku Kingdom just in front. loving in the orders of true love. You follow me, friends, young people? Hindi totoo yung pusong bato na makapagmamahal. You need a transformation, if not a transplanting of heart in order to love something. You know why? Because a calcified heart, a stony heart, will only want something to receive in the benefit of love. It will minimize its act of giving and maximize on what it could receive. That's why it's impossible to experience true love with a stony heart. Pagka stony heart, ang isip na niya parati ay makabig. O anong pakinama ko dito? Even the choices will also be towards self. Selfishness. Self-centeredness. Ayan, okay niya kasi maayos ang pamilya niya. Okay niya kasi maraming pera yan. O okay na yan kasi doktor na yan. It will always be for self-gain. But a heart that comes from God thinks more of giving than receiving. It is a true love that a man or a woman gives until there's nothing more to give. So that it is described in the Gospels, Jesus said, no greater love as man than to lay down. That is exactly all you've got. Your life. Even life itself is not with him in true love. Kaya hindi na po yung sa pag nagmahal ka, 50-50 lang. It is not when 50 bucks sa iyo. Oh goodness. Where did you find that doctrine in the scriptures? In love, all is given. Of course, I do not mean that illicit sexual relationship must be yielded as well. In true morals, God asks us to give everything with God, with and over ourselves, without sacrificing our relationship. That's why the bedrock, the foundation of every successful relationship that will carry the phrase, I'll go home with you, is a true love in Christ. Unless you find that as the foundation of your relationship, you will never get to that point of I'll go home with you. Yes, young people. It must, there must be a change of heart before you can share with that special someone. O sa doon, meron ko ngayon, may sweetheart na ako ngayon. Ano pang gagawin? So mag-break. And you might want to stay longer this afternoon for me to answer that. Unconventional. Because what I believe, love overlooks, makes a space for the mistakes of others, that by it, we can showcase what God's love is, and that they may appreciate the love of God for you. At the Rosis, is the hardening of the body. Come on, Dr. Susan. What is atherosclerosis? course, this is the Artemis that builds up the deposits or we call clouds that eventually makes it impossible for blood to be supplied across the entire body, even to the extremities. The eruption of this eventually can cause failure of the heart, stroke, or heart attack. Am I right? In the same manner, what's different with this atherosclerosis, which could be actually noted as also arteriosclerosis, is that instead of any other element, it thinks that there is more of the deposits of facts and of its life. And that an abrasion of it can cause it that way. With all these fact deposits and with the same outcome of arteriosclerosis. Why am I telling you this one? Because arteriosclerosis is considered a heart problem. In the spiritual condition, marami ang nagsisunod heart na mayroong spiritual arteriosclerosis. When we begin to invite and assimilate the things of this world and deposit it in the medium and passage of our meaningful relationship with God, and eventually blocks any communication with God, it will deter us to continue in a healthy relationship with Him. You see, young people, it's important first to establish a relationship with the author of love so that you can continue loving that other person. By the time you finish, they say, in a span, 10 to 15 years, you will discover that the woman or man you married is not as you have known him or her from the beginning. And when that happens, and you do not imbibe or have that relationship with God that allows you to love someone whom you cannot naturally love, then your relationship will also take toll and head downward. In this university, you are invited to experience Christ first. Let me read to you Ezekiel 11:19-20, as was read a while ago, and draw three important things before we take our lunch. How can we have a heart of flesh over a stony heart? Now, you may not directly understand it in terms of your romantic relationship with that someone, but eventually we'll be able to see a very close relationship that when you're right with God, it will follow as a consequence that you are right with that special someone. Verse 19. Have you opened your Bibles? Have you launched your Bible apps? Scroll down straight to Ezekiel chapter 11. Then you find verse 19. In context, Ezekiel had the opportunity to speak and record the words of God in redeeming or in forgiving the wayward nation of Israel back to Himself. If Jeremiah had the opportunity to say, who can search your heart? And I, only God, can do that. Ezekiel take your pen, and I want you to do a cross-sectional of these verses. Because in verse 19 it says, I will give them an undivided heart. Did you notice that? And a new, come on. Let me have you the experience of Bible scholars do in the research. So at least you will have an each of them. Let me go through it again. Let me read it. In obtaining a flesh heart that follows God's will, it is said, I will give, who is I? God. I will give them an undivided heart. Mark that number one. And put a new spirit. Mark that number two. I will remove from them the heart of stone and give them a heart of flesh. Mark that number three. Did you get it? Now, go over the next phrase. It will highlight again the three, but in a different respect now. Then it will follow. Then they will follow the what? Decrees. And be careful to keep my laws. Mark that letter A. Are you following? Then they, where am I now? They will be my people, part that never be. And I will be their God, mark that never see. Did you get it? Okay. You will notice in its beautiful cross that one is highlighted or understood by letter A, and two with B, and three with C. Did you get it? So, when you say, I will give them an undivided heart, when God said that, what he actually meant was what? Come on, what's letter A? You don't get what we say this. If you don't get your Bible with you, you will sleep. But I want you to see how beautiful the cross is. When God said, I will give them an undivided heart, equate that with A. What does A tell you? That we are. Huh? Come on, what's letter A? Did I ask you to mark them? I will give them an undivided heart. You mark that one, right? What's letter A? Follow my decrees and be careful to keep my laws. When God wanted to give you a flesh heart over your stony heart, he wanted you to have an undivided heart. And what does that mean? That you will follow his decrees, judgments, and instructions. You will be careful to obey me. That is what is meant by having an undivided heart. Before you could love and special someone, offer your love to him. One must be of one purpose in Christ. It could never be undivided. I'm sorry, it could never be divided. No wonder the New Testament counsels us, do not be equally or unequally yoked with unbelievers. Because God knew that in order for love to happen, it must be what? Undivided. I don't know with you, but would you want someone to share love with another woman or a man? Or probably share with a man the love of your boyfriend? Or share with a woman the love of your girlfriend? Think about it, friends. see young people? How many of us are guilty of doing that? We're committing. You may not say, you may say, but you are also showing the same to me, show kindness and affection to someone. Planting them in the near future, it may what? Yield me fruit of acceptance. And do the same with another. Magpapakita ka dito ng magandang loob. Kamukha mo, bitbitin mo mga gamit ka, kabibigan ka ng mga libro, ng textbook. And you know, when it's a help of a friend or a help of someone interested in you, right? Pero, ganun din yung pinapakita niya sa iba. E bakit? Tapos ang sasabihin niya, when you begin to somehow, no, something that needs to make that, ang sasabihin ng pagbawin sa iyo, bakit? Pag sweetheart na tayo. It is dangerous when we trifle with words. Gentlemen, be careful with your show or acts of kindness. Bakit mo sa akin, gumawa ka ng pagbubi sa iba? At mga kapali. Alam mo naman yung nagawa na may mutiri na tayo. Hindi ba?
Be very
relationship. Ikaw ang lumi. Bakit? The gentleman is enjoying the affection without what? The commitment. Feeling kayo, pero baka siya pangako. Because the Spirit wants to give more than receive. And so should we. Pagkakis pagkakun na si Jacob of the Dinan Parang. And you have yielded a commitment to him. Make sure that you are motivated to improve him rather than what? Embellishing yourself with the advantages that you get from him. You get it, ladies? In the same way that you did kayo mga lalaki. When you decide to commit yourself to that someone, think of what can you contribute to the betterment of that person. That is good. It does not seem too much to gain for itself, but to contribute to the personhood of that other person. Kaya ang true love, inahanap niya, paano mapapaligid itong aking sweetheart, itong aking asawa, nang dahil sa akin. Hindi yung ano ang pakinabang ko sa babaeng ito. You follow? Does it make sense to you? That's why you need to understand the character. Because you will find out if the character is already exuding the spirit of giving rather than what? Self-gain. By the time in your life na ikaw ay nakakasawa na, Dok, ikaw ang tulog. Walang makinama ko. May asawa na tulog kayo? Wala. Pero may panapala na yung asawa, di ba? Malapit na. Tinapos ko na yung issue na yung kanina, di ba? I have told you already that God desires you to be married. By default, you are created to be married. It is only on God's special intervention and calling that you will live a celibate life. For His purpose and not for self-gain. Pagdating ng panahon at una kang nawala, ilayo naman. But what has to die again over the body? Kapag din kukulit sa sabay na kayo, unless we need to lalas it, or whatever happened, no? Binahal kayo, o sa kumulit kayo, para may nakakayo. But usually, what has to live out, what has to outlive the body? Sequence. What is most important to acknowledge is that the other person in his or her lifetime with you was better than if you never came into his life. Kaya yung iba sinasabi, ina mo, ang napangasama mo is you. Kung hindi, ako, wala ka. It should be that way. What we contribute to the other person must be our goal. What you contribute, most especially to the personhood of that individual. Dapat ganito siya, napabalik. Dapat ganito siya, ganito. Are you following me? Hindi yung, ay, pagkaya na pang asawa ko, iigi ang buhay ko. Goodness. Those are selfish motives that do not take part. Look, go over the spirit, the character of the spirit, how God is described in 1 Corinthians 13. That's the spirit of true love. That's what God said. Hindi mo pwede. I need to place my spirit in you. Why? Yung spirit in you, evil, wicked, deceitful. That's why God has to replace it. God wants you to be His spirit. He takes possession in a manner that the person grows and matures rather than not.
be spoiled or ruined.
So I hope, in thinking of love to that special someone, tinatanong yung mga sarili natin, ano bang mayaman ba ko sa buhay niya? Kung wala ka, we should ask, where's your last one? grow together. The last, and let me end with this. What's number three? I will. Come on. I will remove from them their heart of stone and give them a heart of flesh. What does that mean? Go to letter C. Then what are you doing? Let number three says, I will kill, I will remove from them the heart of stone and replace it with the heart of flesh. What does that mean? Check letter C and it will tell you. It simply meant, I will be their God. It means God will take charge. You see, you cannot change or transform your character alone. You wouldn't even recognize your deceitful heart. It takes a super being like God, the Creator, to transform your heart. That's why you will notice right from the beginning of the verse, it is divine in shape. It will also be divine completed. God said in the beginning, I will keep them an undivided life. Right? Whose initiative is the transformation? God's initiative. Then he said, I will change their heart of stone and give them a heart of flesh, and I will be their God. It ends at what? It is completed by God. God does not start anything and does not complete. What He started, He will also what? Complete. That's how God loves us. Isn't it awesome that the God who loves us will never forsake us, will never abandon us, will never leave us? Worse than when we first started working with us. When God loves you, when God loves you, we will be the persons He wanted us to be. And what's even hopeless beyond that, He will allow you to love another person. Oh, what an amazing God. Remember, friends, you cannot love that person, that special someone, by yourself. Ang sabi ng nanay ko, kinakailangan mayroon kang Santo Cristo sa dibdib para magpatawad, magmahal ng makapangit ang ugali. And you will discover many of that when you're already there. Kasi ngayon eh, pag nagkita kayo, tingin mo sa kanya, si Superwoman, ang tingin niya sa iyo, si Hercules. Love that. But pretty soon, before you know it, oh, sa bawat isang maganda ng tao yan, siya magpangit. Sa sakit naman, ang brief, kumakayo ng mag-isa. Hindi makapaglaban. Want to know your friends? Start going around visiting the homes of your friends together as magkanya. There is less vulnerability. Di ba? Ikaw mag-isa ka sa magkanya sa bahay ni Pekka, mag-news ka. But when you have good friends around you, you go happy, home happy, not house happy. That's a good practice. O sa ano ha, doon naman tayo ha, pagpapalit eh. Wala pa rin nagbubuhod. Pero pag nagbubuhod na kayong dalawa, mawala na. Remember, halimbawa, ito, magkasabal ka na yan. Diyan. Huh? May conflict sila as friends. Kasama ka siya. Saan? Barkada. Pero pag nag-single ha, kayong dalawa, towards each other. Yan lahat ng mga kaibigan na madidibalitan. And you will be vulnerable. You see? E pa paano kung si Seth, nananalangin ka? Ha, Seth? Ikaw, nananalangin ka kay Jeko. Si thing. So, it will end observation, di ba? It will end observation. Tapos na. May nangyari na eh. But when you're together as friends, there are all opportunities to observe until the right time. Oh yes. Young people, there is so much to learn in that one thing called love. But one sure principle, when you have Christ in your life, what he started, he also completes. I wish it would end up with that now. When God says, I will be their God. He puts himself in a duty. He puts himself in a promise. He puts himself in a relationship with you. Whether you would respond right or not, he will love you the same. That's one good thing with my God. His, the character of his love is never dependent on your response. That's why he allows you to choose the blessings or the curse. But God remains the same. You'll never find a boyfriend like Christ. You'll never find a girlfriend as perfect as Christ. But the closer you seek for his character, more likely, you will be the first to trust him. The more you get closer to Christ, ikaw ang una na mababago. Bago si Jenna. Bago si Jeko. Why? Saan nila matatanda? Yung malapit sa ulingan, siya unang mauulingan. The closer you come to Christ, the more you imbibe the principles of love. Because Christ is no other than love himself. Young people, I don't want to go through a lot of questions talking about the dynamics of love. I'd like to ground you on this principle. How does God change a pusong bato? Three things I know. First, he will give you an undivided heart. That meant he will ask you to remain faithful in obedience to his bidding. And when you learn to obey, when you learn to respect, when you are humble to follow, it will never be difficult to love that unlovable man. It will never be difficult to love that nothing woman. Number two, after an undivided heart, he said, I will put a new spirit. It deducts the principle of heart, the principle of love, that God will also replace our heart. He will seek to develop in us the fruit of the spirit, the character of true love. And one thing more, he will make sure will be developed. You will be distinct. You will be understanding. You will excel like a diamond, for you are the apple of his eyes. And the last, I will remove from you that stony heart, and I will replace it with flesh. That meant, I want to be and when God makes that promise, he completes it. Young people, make first the relationship with God, and you'll discover the rest will follow with that special sound when the right time and the right person comes along.
If God can replace our calcified hearts with his pure and faithful love toward us, replacing our calcified hands, not to be faithful in freely giving what belongs to Him through tithes and offering. Before our deacons will serve us, let me share some Bible verses written by Paul in 2 Corinthians, chapter 9, verses 6 to 9. It reads, "But this I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and he who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. So let each one give as he purposes in his heart, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God allows a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace and abound toward you, that you, always having all sufficiency in all things, may have an abundance for every good thing." Now our deacons are ready to serve us. Faithful Father, we thank you for the faithful hearts who have shared the blessings to be used in blessing others as well. We thank you for the hands who work hard just to be part of touching the hearts of others through you. We thank you for the joy of giving and sharing of what you have given to us. May all of this be used to help others with you.
For our people who have consecration that we can all say, "He's so sweet, just like Jesus."
Seek to understand the offer of God. May the Father